Now that I have a really good working knowledge of the color mixes and the structure of the leaf and the approach, the second painting will appear to move much more quickly. Now I'm going to keep the original painting next to the one I'm working on to ensure that I'm keeping the same harmony and structure. Notice how much more quickly I'm able to sketch in a leaf. While I was painting it the first time, my mind was capturing each piece of the leaf through intense observation and study. That's one of the many values of the mantra, learn, paint, repeat. From the first round of painting, I recognized that I could go with a much larger brush to block in the shades. Here I'm using a number 8 Rosemary & Company long flat. Using a clean brush with a little bit of Gamsol to lift off some paint, I'm going to redefine the lightest areas of the veins. And then I'm going to continue to paint the rest of the leaf and just refine it until I'm ready to paint in the shadows. Thank you. In the first painting, I used the Rosemary & Company comber for the edges. I felt like I didn't get the sharp edge like I wanted, so here I switched to the number 3 Rosemary & Company Evergreen Long Flat, and was much more pleased with the result. Experimentation is key. Don't be afraid to try something new, and if you don't like something, lift it off or blend it in, or even wait a day until it dries.